Video recorded. Hi, this is Crystal's Creations. Can y'all hear me? We're going to do another video called St. Paddy's Shaker Card. And this is the card, just so you know. So you can see it. This is the card I'm going to do. So here it is. So I already made one, because I have to post a picture of a card first on YouTube, because that is the protocol. So here's one that we're going to make today. Not with the same pattern background, but that's kind of very similar as what we're going to make today. So I'm going to show you how to make some little shakers. And this is from the Stamps of Life, St. Paddy's stamp kit. And here's another one I did the other day. It's a leprechaun shaker card I did from some St. Paddy's cardstock I got on Amazon. Nobody carries any St. Paddy's Day. Nobody's carrying any St. Paddy's Day stuff these days, and I don't know why. But there's that. It's the inside of the card. And then a little sticker that came with the cardstock kit. So, there you have it. So, and here's a little shaker I already made. What do you call these? Shamrocks? I'm Irish. I should know this. Right? I'm Irish and British. I should know these things. But I don't always know these things because I always forget because of what I have. So, let's put this camera where hopefully you can see me work and see my work that I do. Okay? Okay, I will try and get the cord out of the way. So we are going to work on the... What shall we work on? The horseshoe, the gold, or the shamrock? Let's do the shamrock. So I'm going to do... My plastic... The acetate that goes on top of the thing. So I cut out a glittered cardstock. And the glittered thing that I'm using is none other than I'm using a... Let me find the name of the book. Hold on, let's see if I can find it. In my stash of stuff down here. Oh no, my phone just fell. I don't know where I put it. Oh, phone. Stay sideways, please. Just stay. So I know you're still working, right? Still recording me? Okay. Just work. Okay. Scrap that. Maybe we won't do that. Okay? So let me get out my glue. I just got this new glue called Barely Glue. Let me tell you, barely. Hashtag barely glue. This stuff is amazing. Oh my gosh, I love it. If you have issues like CRPS, like complex regional pain syndrome, carpal tunnel, arthritis, or whatever else you might have in your hands, wrists, arms like I do, in your legs perhaps, then this is the glue for you. Because let me tell you, this stuff comes out like awesome. So I'm going to grab a scratch piece of paper here, make sure my glue is coming out. I'll make sure I did this right. I'll have to poke my cleaning tool down there. Good, now we're coming out. Yay, that works. Woohoo! So I'm going to take a clover. Well, clover, shamrock, whatever you want to call it. It doesn't take much glue to glue these on. So we're going to quickly do this. I'm not very good at this. So, hopefully you guys are all having a good weekend. It's really nice out there in Colorado today, nice and sunny. My husband is outside trimming all the flowers out there. Now I'm gonna apply this to the glittered cardstock that I got at Michael's. And make sure it's kind of even, because this is where your shaker gems are going to go in. This will just help me hold it better while I apply my other layers of shamrocks. And I do about 7 layers of the green shamrocks. I do 6 layers, and then I do my acetate layer, and then I do another layer of green on top of that. So, let's get another one ready to go. And I've got dinner already going in the crock pot. And I've got, oh, people are texting me. I should have told them I was doing a video shoot. But anyways, I got dinner in a crock pot. It's a enchilada slow cooker thing. I hope I can eat it. I don't know if I can. But I have a bit of a ulcer issue going on in my stomach. There's a little stress going on due to some certain friend or family member stressing me out. But it is what it is. That's okay. That's okay. Okay, I'll look at the text later. I'll look at it later. I'm doing a video. I'm doing a video. Quit texting right now. I'll look at the text later. I can't stop right now. I'm trying to get this done. So, great. And the text just don't stop. Hope that doesn't come over my video. Okay, let's get another layer. Okay. And there. Now I'll put this layer on. This is our third one. And try to make sure it's perfectly even. I don't know if you guys can see that. You guys see that? I don't know. Try to see what I'm doing here. I'm just trying to make sure this is even. So. Okay, and we're gonna go with number 4. Ah, my glue, I'm not very good at this. This is really difficult. That's okay. Yum. Yeah. So yeah, like I said, a friend of mine let me borrow this stamp set. She has a thing with a subscription with the Stamps of Life. And she gets the stamp and die set box every month. And not so she let me borrow it because I thought it was really cute. And I have a neighbor that has a girl next door that has a birthday on St. Paddy's Day. And I thought, oh, let's make her a St. Paddy's Day card for her birthday. That'd be really cute. And then she gave me, out of the kindness of her heart, she gave me, see, they've moved. That phone is plugged in and it's, she gave me, oh, it's over here. Let's see if I can move a little. Show you guys real quick. She gave me this box called Happy Mail from the Stamps of Life. So, I'll show you real quick. Okay? So, in this box is little dragonfly, the flower, and, a die that says take it easy, which I learned how to do a technique, a bookmark die, which I could do a bookmark card with this, the outside of it, where it clips over your book when you're reading a book. So it looks really cool. So I learned it from Jennifer McGuire. So I'll have to teach you guys how to do this too. It's really fun. So it'll be fun to make. So I'm happy for this. So I thank her for this. So I haven't done any of this stuff yet. So this is the dragonfly kit. So I'm going to have to do some shakers and stuff with this too. So there's that. Those dragonflies. And then the stamps. Wishing you a lovely day and hello beautiful. And then this one is, you got this. I'm proud of you. Thank you. Spread your wings. Time flies when I'm with you. Dream. I miss you. Be you. Stamps and whatnot. And then it comes with this beautiful cardstock, 6x6 cardstock kit, double-sided stuff, which I know I can probably make cards with. And the dies that it comes with, actually, you can use, I'll show you. Let me see if I can find it. You can use the dies, the coordinating dies, to cut out these dies to cut out those dragonflies out of the cardstock. Now, how cool is that? That is so cool. So you don't have to use your fussy cutting scissors to do that, which gives my hands a break because of that crazy autoimmune disease. And the same thing with these, too. These ones. I think you can use the little guy. The little dragonfly, too. You can cut out some of these little ones, too. Which would be so fun to do. So that would be fun. So lots of cool cardstock. Paper. Colors. Which I'm sure some of you have already seen. Lisa Mears. Do. Stamps of Life. And all that. Hearts. Take it easy. And then it repeats and whatnot. So. And then it came with a thing of gems. And some card kit ideas on how to design my cards. And a thing of flowers, and then some chipboard dragonflies, and envelopes, and ribbon things it came with, and then some cardstock to make the cards with, so that'll be fun to do, so it'll be fun, plus I give my friend rides to her eye doctor appointments, so that, it was a good trade-off for this, So be looking out for videos for these coming up. So I will be doing that. So, but I just thought I'd show you guys. I know I never really show you guys videos of what I get in mail. I know everybody else shows videos of what they get and stuff, but I guess I could show y'all. So, alright. Oh, let's get back to this. So what was this? Layer 4? So let's go to layer 5. So this is layer 5. Whoop, don't get it on the cardstock inside because we don't want our gems to stick. My hand can't do this. Yep. Okay. And then I'm just gonna lay that on top of that. That way you guys can see what I'm doing. Glue, trying to get it as straight as I possibly can. Okay. And then we're going to put our shaker pieces in here. Now this glue does dry clear, so don't worry about it if it's white. Number 6 on. Then you're probably wondering how I got it like this, how I got it so thin, the shamrock like this. I wanted to be prepared. So I'll show you. So what you do is you take your